First, Erin, thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it. How did you end up involved in this case?
Well, back in December, I had been contacted by a couple of the community members in Leroy, and one of them was a family member whose daughter had been affected. And I, like everybody else, you know, kind of watched this story unfold, and it kind of hit the media very, very quickly, and there was a sudden diagnosis.
It seemed to sort of fade, and it sort of disappeared.
It did.
Did you have the same reaction I did? The diagnosis seemed didn't feel right in your gut, and then it kind of closed the door on further investigation?
Well, I think the first thing that hit me in my gut was, well, you haven't necessarily ruled anything and everything in or out. It was just seemed to be a very quick diagnosis. And what happened very quickly after it got into the media was one of the family members, somebody put a note in their mailbox, and it was about a 1971 derailment, and the contaminated rock and fill and soil was used to build the new school.
So slow down. You found out. This is something you then were able to corroborate?
We are still trying to corroborate that. So what I did immediately research it, I went online, and lo and behold, in 1971, there was a very serious train derailment that caused 1 ton of cyanide to spill and 45,000 gallons of TCE.
Okay, TC is trichloroethylene. Is that the same thing that was in your story that became a movie?
No, Hinckley was hexavalent chromium.
Trichloroethylene is a well-known carcinogen.
Yes.
Can it also cause these sorts of neurological problems?
I have read and been involved in cases that we have that TCE can be associated with neurological disorders.
Okay, so here we have a train derailment 40 years ago,
correct,
right? How does a train derailment 40 years ago, nearby the school, right, nearby this community,
correct,
how far away?
Well, the actual location of the site of the derailment is 4 miles from the school.
4 miles from the school. There's a massive train derailment with spectacular exposure of known carcinogens and toxins. There's a map of where this happened right now. How did that then become an issue for the high school?
Well, this is what we're looking into, and the Agencies for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry did not get out to this spill site until the 90s, as did the EPA.
So it happened, and it took them 20 years to go out there and investigate this.
20 years to go out and investigate.
Wow.
So by the time they had gotten out there and investigated, this contamination was in the bedrock. They concluded it's called a Dean apple, a dense aqueous phase liquid. The concentrations are so heavy that this agency had to dilute those samples just to get a reading.
Okay, I want to make sure I get this. I want to make sure, because I'm really kind of hearing this for the first time in its complete story. You've given me bits and pieces of this. So there was so much in the bedrock.
Correct.
It was so present that it exceeded their ability to measure it. They couldn't even, was too high to measure.
Correct.
They had to dilute it in order to measure it and then extrapolate back from the dilutions.
Correct.
And it was so fluid that it was spreading in the bedrock?
Correct. And they have a phenomenon that this agency has reported that every year when the water table rises, this bedrock is submerged and pulses of TCE in this contaminant come out and go into the groundwater, and it has created a plume. In 1999, they confirmed that that plume was 4 miles to the east, southeast, and at the leading edge of this groundwater plume, it was a mile wide.
Okay, so at the leading edge, here we are again, 4 miles would put it right at the high school, would it not?
It is. Yes. When I first read this document and I contacted some of the family members, I said, how far is the school from the site?
It might even put it at the athletic field that has come into question, where family has reported seeing strange things coming up.
Family has reported that there's an orange-yellow substance that almost kind of oozes from the ground.
There's the field now we're showing on the video there.
Is on the children's clothing, their shoes.
This is a dramatic finding. And why has it taken this long? When they found it in 99, why didn't they do something about it?
Well, in 99, they did. They were supposed to get into a pre-remedial design and looking at a soil vapor extraction system. They did a lot of detail here.
Who did?
The Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease
Registry.
That's
a state agency or a federal agency?
It's federal agency.
Okay, and
they concluded that this plume was not defined in 99. That if it was not remediated, it would continue to go on indefinitely.
Well, why didn't they do something or notify people? Isn't this the question?
I've done a lot of these environmental cases for 21 years, and I've never yet seen a case until today that it took an agency 20 years to respond. I'm a disappointment wouldn't describe to you how I feel. At this point, I'm very concerned about this.
First of all, I don't know for sure. One thing I wanted to connect all these dots, I want to know, apparently trichloroethane can break down into vinyl chloride, is a neurotoxin.
Correct.
And so I want evidence that connects the dots biologically here. Mm-hmm. But even if this turns out not to be the cause of the tick thing, I bet if you and I went up there and examined the cemeteries, you would see a lot of, or the death certificates, you'd see a lot of cancer, a lot of infant deaths, way more than average, even if it's not specifically related to this particular case.
That's true, and that's already starting to be reported. And what we're concerned about...
This is very dramatic, Erin. This is like very disturbing, to say the least. If I lived in... I hope we're not adding to a panic in a community that is already upset. Mm-hmm. I'm feeling a little panicky just reporting this, and I don't live under the trichloroethylene plume.
Well, here's how we feel about it. And I've been inundated with emails from people all across America and from Leroy. And they've reported several things to us that are of concern beyond just this. And that is that where the old school is, there is a creek, and there has been known chemical dumping. And some of the children report playing in that creek as children and uncovering 55-gallon barrels.
Oh, my goodness.
We don't know what. The school has 5 natural gas wells underneath its property.
This is the old school.
No, the new school. What we're concerned about with that is not that these gas wells, which were not disclosed, could be harming the kids, but it could be controlling the migration of the plume.
It could be concentrating it right there.
It could be pulling it to them. And our concern is
These are the gas wells we're looking at here. Are they used to fund the school? Or is there a reason they would have an issue to protect those gas wells?
Well, they're owned by the school, and the school does make money off of them.
Okay.
And that is a concern for migration of the plume.
Keeping the plume at the school. It's
possibly
a beautiful school. It's sad to think. Okay, I can't even get my mind go there. Let me talk quickly to the reporter. Okay. Evan, you broke this story. Here we are. We're reporting something that Erin has investigated very carefully. How do we keep people from flying into a panic here? How concerned is the community?
Some of the concern, really, we talked about in the newsroom over the past few weeks when we've been looking at this. There, when we first heard that conversion disorder may have been the cause, parents initially were told that. It seemed that adding more attention to it at the time could have really kind of added to the issue. And obviously, it went national, so there's going to be more attention. Erin's looking into this. There is that, but I tell you, from people that I spoke with in Leroy when I was there, it's been a little bit. I went there earlier in the month. They just seemed like they had a lot of questions and they were more frustrated. I don't know that the hysteria is really, maybe that's the wrong word to use, but panic, as you'd said, is the way that they're seeing it right now.
Good. I mean, that's good. Please, please keep everybody, going about their business. Erin is on the job. You're going up there, yeah?
We have a team out there. They're on their way there now.
I'm going to send part of my team up there with you, if you don't mind.
No, they'll be there.
I myself want to get up there as soon as I possibly can. It may be next week or so.